Hi, I'm Henry, and here's a little bit of an overview about our greenhouses. Let's open it up and check it out.
Yeah, I mean, it's not too bad with the manual.
No, the way it's geared, it's still pretty quick.
Yeah. You have to have the strength to hold your wrist straight because there is some torque on it. And you want to watch out that you don't, like, if it gets twisted like that and can't turn, then it's going to rip it out of your wrist. So you got to, like, watch that. It saves a lot of time. Yeah, in the spring when we're opening and closing them, you know, every day, a couple times a day, it definitely is a time saver. So these are our high tunnels here. We've got two up and two more going in just like them. Probably the most interesting thing about them is this roll-up end wall design that we copied from Sassafras Creek down in Maryland. There's a few other people doing similar things. But we love it because of the tractor access and also just ventilation in the summer. I think it helps create a good growing environment in there for all kinds of things. You can also see our trellis system for the tomatoes here that we've got. Rigged it up just because the end wall is not, you know, a full end wall, so I didn't want to put as much strain pulling in with the top wires. So I dropped the wire down to these T-posts and then braced it with a couple fence tensioners we had lying around. So far it's been working pretty good. It seems to distribute, you know, the load across the whole thing instead of focusing it on just a couple points. Tomatoes were going in and I needed to figure something out real quick, and this is what I came up with. It's worked okay so far. Nothing's failed. I've only tightened it on installation, so I just, you know, tensioned it with this piece of wood and twisting it, wrapping it around, and then it was pulling that first brace in a little bit, so I added the fence tensioners there to prevent the first bow from getting pulled inwards. And so far I haven't had to add any more attention to it. I just did it once. We'll see, you know, when the tomatoes are 9 feet tall and full of fruit, they may be putting more stress on it, but I think I can just tighten them up again.